bad nutrition and healthy diet costs a lot of money. And it's made basically of two components. One of them has to do with the costs related with health problems that are the result of unhealthy diet. So increase in diabetes, increase in hypertension, increase in obesity, particularly in children, cardiovascular diseases and cancer. You know, treatment, health-related costs are huge. So unhealthy diets pose a huge burden in the health systems. And on the other hand, there's also the cost for the individuals in terms of affording a healthy diet. Sometimes healthier foods are more expensive. So sometimes if you want to increase your number of fruit and vegetables every day, you would need to spend more money. So foods with lots of sugar and fats and salts tend to be relatively more inexpensive than foods that are more complex and foods that are essential elements of our diet and our life, but they normally cost a little bit more. So our priorities in terms of diet and physical activity is basically to contribute to the prevention of non-communicable diseases related with these risk factors, diet and physical inactivity. Particularly thinking about obesity, diabetes, cancer, and cardiovascular diseases, these can be largely prevented if we improve diets and the levels of physical activity of the population. So it's one of our major priorities because 80% or more than 80% of health and, you know, of death and disability in Europe are attributable to non-communicable diseases. So we really need to prevent them. Well, success looks like achieving the WHO targets for 2025 and 2030 of a 10% decrease of physical inactivity, that we at least ensure that childhood obesity and adult obesity will not increase again by 2025, and that we reduce the consumption of sugar, saturated fat, total fat, and that we can increase the consumption of fruit and vegetables, for example.